Once your chicken fried steak gets done cooking, dump out your grease and then whatever, you leave just a little bit in there so that you can cook your flour. All right, you get your flour. All right, be careful not to put too much in, because if you do, you're gonna have to add a little bit more grease. So just put a little flour in there, like so. And stir it in there, let it cook. All right, while that's cooking, I am going to add some pepper. Add as much or little as you want. All right, stir that in there. Get the sides. You want to get all those little crumbly bits in there, because that's what makes your gravy taste good. All right, now once you let this cook for a little bit and you get that flour taste out, you go ahead and you can start adding your milk. Keep stirring while you're adding. Get your sides. May not look like it'll thicken, but trust me, it will thicken. Now, if you want, you can go ahead and start adding in your sugar. 4. Whoa. I don't know exactly how much that was. I don't measure. So just put as much sweetness as you would like in your gravy. If you don't want, just take some back. Just put in as much as you would prefer your gravy to be sweet. See, it's already starting to thicken. Just a little bit longer. And while you're cooking your gravy, do not adjust the temperature on your stove from when you're cooking the chicken fry. Leave it the same. All right. That looks perfect. Do a little taste. Perfect. Now you can turn off your stove, set it to the side, and you're done.